Hi, my name is Andreas and I work as a field application engineer at G&D. For years, IP technology has become increasingly important and the wish to integrate KVM components into network infrastructures has grown. Many applications benefit greatly from the use of IP, so let's have a closer look at this technology. G&D's portfolio includes solutions for both classical KVM and KVM-over-IP. In this video, we will learn about the difference between the two technologies and we will talk about challenges and advantages with the IP transmission. We will start with our KVM extenders. Classic KVM extenders from G&D are used to extend your PC or server in a one-to-one connection with our own proprietary protocol. This means that we use dedicated cabling from the CPU to the CON module. It can be copper for distances up to 140 meters, fiber multimode for connections up to 400 meters, or fiber single mode for distances up to 10 kilometers. A KVM over IP extender can be connected to a network infrastructure. The system don't need dedicated point-to-point connection as the signals can be bundled over the network with uplinks. The transmission works with a single network switch, a network topology like a star, a tree, or a mesh network. The network requirements are very simple in the extender mode. A layer 2 network switch works pretty well as the devices works in the unicast mode. One main advantage is that you can pass many CPUs to many consoles via one uplink in your network. As you remember, for classic KVM, we need a single dedicated transmission for each connection. To keep your network traffic clean, you can adjust the bandwidth in the CPU module. The bandwidth limitation provided by G&D on the CPU side helps our users to perfectly adjust the bandwidth. Based on standard IP networks, the system uses 1 gigabit technology for the transmission. If you have more or less static content with less changes like radar screens, for example, you can reduce the bandwidth down to 100 Mbit per second. To compare, we recommend a bandwidth of 300 to 400 Mbit for a single link, 500 to 600 Mbit for a dual link, and 800 to 900 Mbit for a UHD resolution in standard office applications. Another advantage of the KVM over IP series is that we have transferred our own protocol to the IP layer. Let me explain this in one more detail. With our classic KVM extenders, we use the whole bandwidth of the physical layer for the KVM transmission with our own protocol. Since KVM over IP is based on the IP protocol, we only have to add the required bits for the IP protocol stack. In this case, we need bytes for the encryption, the UDP datagram and the IP packet. Just as important as the video transmission is the user experience while working on the system. This is why we prioritize the keyboard and mouse data with quality of service for the best hand-eye feedback with a non-delay feeling. I believe you are familiar with our KVM over IP extenders now. But what if I have bigger installations or need a metric system? Do I need other devices or licenses? For this scenario, we simply add our control center IP. The model becomes the central unit and takes over all metrics tasks. For example, user management, device management, and also our features like push-get or cross-display switching. We will learn more about this next time. So, thank you for watching. For questions or more information, you can visit our website, check the links in the video description, or contact us directly. Until then, take care.